get reset. They have to take. They have to win six games in a row because they've already lost a set. Pelican DM have not lost a single set today, so they still have that extra life to play with. So here we go. Final destination. We got we got Pikachu Libre coming in.
I'm liking it.
I love this character from Pokken. That was my main dog.
I still haven't yet to play Pokken, but obviously DM disgusting with the Pika Libre right here. And right now, as you said, Pokken DM have yet to lose a set in this entire game. To lose a game, really. I've yet to see. And right now, it's a lot tougher for Six and Uno, who are on that grind, who are on that gauntlet right now, who have had to play more games. While Pelka and DM have had that waiting time, they have more stamina right now, and they really got to just focus in as much as possible and take out especially what has been the most dominant team today.
Now, Drex, I want to point something out here. This is a song we don't hear very often.
It's not.
And I love it. So I just want to take a moment to just appreciate the music. Let's just listen for a bit. I feel like the waterfalls are too loud. Whatever.
I can't even hear it over the panel.
There's too much going on. But anyways, let's jump back into it. Man. We got six stocks. You got blue team already taking away two from New England. That's going to be 6WX flying into the screen.
Right now, Pelka offstage. Uno keeping a good job of keeping him off. Won't let Pelka land. There's that down tilt off. Trying to find something, but no avail. That down tilt, that down air just did not work. Pelka with the dash tech sending Uno far off himself. Grenade coming out and hitting Six high up with that back air. Now, Six with that Arsen. What do you got to do in that situation? The up tilt coming out from Pelka.
Trying his best to get back to the stage. And that's the thing you got to do against Snake. When he's trying to recover low like that, that's the opportune time to, like, you know, wail on him. And you know for a fact DM knows that. So he's going to be there to try to assist his teammate as hard as possible while all that's taking place. Good forward smash from WCWX.
Good forward
a
smash.
Second one. I feel like anytime that 6WX lands a really strong hit on someone, he will always, always land a strong hit on the other opponent because they're trying to go for the punish. They forget that Joker's forward smash has very little cooldown compared to, like, other characters' forward smashes.
It's very strong, too. Very strong.
So I'm trying to get the forward air against Snake. Unfortunately for him, you know, he's got some super armor on that up B, on that Cypher, getting back onto the stage.
Six trying to get in and save Uno from a bad situation with all those back hits from DM, but to no avail, actually basically took the punish himself while not really helping Uno so much. And there's that up tilt once again, and Pelka, that's Pelka's go-to kill option recently.
There was some miscommunication there with Pelka. You saw him trying to get a sticky Pikachu, but DM was a little bit too far away, so he just put it on the ground in front of him. That could have been a devastating combo later on. Uno going off super deep to try to get this Pikachu, because as Inkling, you can afford to go deep. You can recover from anywhere, but good call
and
out from 6WX.
DM's gone.
I mean, yeah, he called the jump out of shield.
Right now, Uno just crawling.
Was that BM? Was that BM? Was that bad manners? You saw him going back and forth while crawling? That's a little sus.
That's a little, somebody needs to just get some manners.
Honestly, but you know what? Sometimes you got to pull out the big stops, man. That's going to be game number one going to 6WX and Uno.
I think that's the first game Pelka and DM have lost all day. I can't remember the last time I saw Pelka and DM lose a game.
I believe it. The thing is, we talked about how we've seen nothing but 3-0s today. So now we know for a fact this will not be a 3-0.
I mean, we could see two 3-0s.
Yeah, I guess that's true. Yeah, you're right. It could be a 6-0. If that happens, wow. Could you imagine?
That would be.
Imagine a world.
Oh, my God. I saw Little Mac on the screen for a second. I got really worried.
No, we're all good. Put that back.
Please,
here we go.
Please.
Jumping back into the next game. Let's get right down to it. Game number two. Got a lead up on 6WX and Uno, the brothers extraordinaire, fighting off against the New England team, Pelka and DM.
And as you said, there was a little miscommunication in that first game between Pelka and DM. It especially could have turned
the tides.
It was
just like a small little moment.
Yeah, it could have turned those tides there. But Six and Uno did a really good job of just keeping constant pressure on them, keeping them off stage as fast as possible, as much as possible, and protecting each other at the same time. And this is what they got to keep doing. They got to make sure that they can stay closer to each other to help each other instead of letting Pelka and DM. I don't know even why I talk. I don't even know.
You just went out there, man. That was sick. Honestly, what can you say? 6WX, good down air, man. You got the
good
spike.
Good down air.
You just got both of them out down at the same time. Belka's going to be able to call out that jump out of shield. Has an up tilt with his name on it.
Trying to call out that forward smash, but didn't read that DM was trying to get closer to the ledge. Yeah. That could have been a bad situation.
Well, DM did recognize last second that it was happening, so that's why he put up his shield.
Because he's like, oh, shoot, there's a missile right in front of my
there
face.
There's a big explosive coming right
a
for
nuclear
me.
Nuclear explosion coming my way. Here we go. DM laying a Nair at his shield. Interesting right there. He, like... So what was interesting, 6WX went for the counter, right? The down B
and
against
DM
Pikachu. But it triggered the reflect from, I think it was a grenade from Pelka. So it left him wide open for DM to try to get a you know, response. Because that down B is both a counter as well as a reflect, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It's a Marakondra and a Tetrakarn, you know?
Man, props to you for actually remembering the full names of that.
I love Persona.
I love Persona 2,
but
I
moves are broken
remember.
In Persona.
They
you
are.
Know? You got to have that on your somewhere on your deck, man. And there we go. Gonna air dodge. Nice call out from Uno. He played patient. He stood still. But DM getting a kill on the other side of the stage before Uno could try to do anything about it. And both Pelka and 6WX already on their last stock.
On the C4 right there also taking out Uno. Uno only on his second stock. DM on his second stock as well. But a lot higher percentage. 138 and 6 just trying to edge guard him as much as he can. Sending him to the other side of the stage. We're going to see here. DM actually coming into the advantage now. Sending both of the brothers off stage.
It's weird that he actually took point right there, because there was a time when DM was, you know, chilling in the back. He's got super high percent. But I think what happened, oh, nice call out, gets the up smash, and this is already gone. They took both the stocks immediately. So now it's a 2v1 again. 6WX is trying to get the down air right out of that rapid jab. Again, they're going to be looking for these team combos. That's like the highlight I love about 6WX and Uno. They're just always on point with getting these combos. The second someone gets a hit, you know the brother is going to be on the other side awaiting to get the follow-up.
They know every little thing about each other's characters, and they know exactly what can follow up from every tiny little hit. But right now, the down tilt coming out. Grenade. That covered a lot of options, actually. That was a really nice play there from Uno.
That was a good call out from 6WX, recognizing that Pikachu is going to land right in front of him with that quick attack. He knew the thunder was coming, so why just call out Arsene, and that thunder actually sealed. Did he die? For a second, I thought maybe he was going to live.
I thought he was going
to
live.
Because he went for a double jump. Because when you're flying out like that in the blast zone, right? Let's watch it again. So, like, when you're in that blast zone, you want to get to the corner of the square. So he goes flying. Here comes the forward smash. He goes for the double jump to give himself some vertical space. And he goes up there, and it was just too late.
Wow.
He still had a lot of momentum coming out, even after the double jump. So he just, like, flew.
It was so long, though. Like,
yeah.
It was, wow.
That was a hot second. But you know what? That's going to be the second game going to the brothers again. One game away from resetting this bracket and having to play one more against the New England duo.
We could see another 3-0 right here.
It's looking close, man. I mean, like I said, they're playing on fire. They lost earlier to Beast and Juice. Granted, that was a best 2 of 3 when they lost 2-1. Never got the chance to fight off against these guys. So maybe they're just not ill-equipped to fight off against Inkling and Joker, or maybe just like this level of synergy. That's like, I honestly keep saying this time and again, but their highlight is how well they are how well they work off of each other.
Absolutely.
So here we go. Let's jump into Kalos Pokemon League. Like kind of a mix-up of a stage, you know, something to work with. These platforms on the edge could help a lot with Snake's recovery, as well as Pikachu's, actually.
Yes, absolutely.
Quick attack gives Pikachu. Them so many different options to get back to the stage.
And right now, like, this is, once again, it's stuff that we said before. Obviously, with Joker, that gauge is so dangerous. But you gotta you can't focus on one or the other. You gotta really spread it out, and you gotta make sure you can separate them as much as possible. Even the little extension from the platforms coming out will send them even farther away, which is a lot better for them. But right now, they gotta make sure that 6 and Uno don't take this stage control. And right, Pelka did a really good job with Uno right there, sending Uno high and far with that up tilt.
Yeah,
if you didn't know, Pelka really likes up tilt.
Yeah, it has a lot of knockback on that move. My man does yoga for days, gets the kicks up there, reaches to the stars every single time. Got the up tilt on the platform. Now we got some stage control for red team. 6WX is going to be able to break that zone with a quick bursting dash attack. Oh, and they both died in the process. He didn't mean to kill his pet Pikachu from behind. That's animal cruelty, man.
That's a lot of cruelty right there.
Okay, I like that decision-making coming from Pelka. He recognized that DM got him, caught him in the vortex of the back air. So he's like, you know what? I'm going to go fight 6WX so he doesn't interrupt this.
And speaking of 6 right now, on the platform, that grenade actually was a little, like, he wanted to back off a little bit so he wouldn't get hit by that grenade.
And you know what? Compared to Brawl Snake, Snake got a huge buff in the terms of being able to go for the directional air dodge.
Oh, absolutely.
Like, that allows him to just be able to let go of that up B. Good fat forward smash coming out from 6WX yet again. Not even giving Pelka the chance to go for a recovery.
Yeah, like, as you were talking about with Ball, like, every single time the Snake would recover, they would have to try the C4. They would have to try for that. But now they actually get a legitimate option that works in their favor. Okay, gonna go for the rapid jab again. Sends him flying.
Snake recovering high.
No techs. You saw him go against the wall. The thing with Kalos Pokemon League is that is a long wall. Because you plenty of time to either go for double jumps or for techs.
The up tilt coming out once again, and DM sending, wow, just on top of six, protecting Pelka right there. But DM being sent high and far. Pelka and Uno on their last two stocks here.
Was that a bait? You saw Uno get the roller against him. And instead of opting to go after him, he just waits for DM to land the dash attack on Pelka to break him out and left himself wide open for 6WX to get the forward smash on DM. I feel like 6WX is just waiting for that entire moment to happen.
That would be an amazing bait out of them right now.
I'm pretty sure that he was just reacting to what was going on. Dang it, going for the Rebel's Guard again as he's trying to land back down on the ground, takes the hit.
Oh, out of ink. Yeah, that rapid jab wasn't working. It was completely out of ink and still is, but no.
Now it's full now.
Gone. Now it's full. But there goes six.
Oh, gosh. It's going to be brutal.
Now this is a dangerous situation right here for Uno. These are the last two characters.
Over.
Yep. These are the last two characters I would want to be stuck against.
Yeah, all Pikachu just needs to touch him.
Oh, now the C4 is actually on Snake now.
It's okay.
Now
it's on it's really easy to transfer that. But you see how good Uno's doing at being able to just try to transfer this C4 between them. And now this is Uno's time to like try to play aggressive so he doesn't get a chance to place that C4 on top of Pikachu.
Rolled into the rapid jab actually. Was safe with that shield. Thought he could roll around him.
Honestly, Uno's doing a pretty good job of, you know, holding his own in this 1v2. It could be insanely struggling. Oh, tried a little bit hair too slow.
Now
trying to get that pickup afterwards. Gonna hold on to that rapid jab for quite a long time because he caught DM in the middle of that shield. I mean, after 11 frames, you know, you can eventually just like go for the roll behind. And wait, Uno's playing out of his mind.
Yeah,
hold on a second.
Uno's doing amazing right now. Like you said, that C4 quick attack is one of the best
options.
There
we go. Finally defusing the 3-0 victories from everyone. Putting a point on the board. New England's back on the map. Pelka and DM not allowing, refusing the bracket reset. Two games away from moving on.
You cannot deny, though, Uno was out of his mind towards the end there. Like, I would not want to face those characters in a 2v1, but Uno was holding his own absolutely and even taking the advantage at times. And, like, that was just a crazy good play coming out from Uno, but it doesn't matter to this point now. And now it comes down to can they still win one more? They have to win one more, and then they have to win three more.
Now they have the counter picks in their favor, which is going to be important, you know?
Just a little.
Whenever, you know, Uno and 6WX going to be able to pick the stage again. Stages are a little less important in terms of doubles because there's, again, four different characters on the screen that all benefit and not benefit from certain stage layouts. Mm-hmm. So it's not going to change the meta too much, but they still, you know, they at least get to decide what stages they don't want to go to.
Yeah. I would say the only thing that could even benefit them slightly is maybe Lilat or Unova for Pelka and DM, where the C4, once the red light goes away, is a little harder to see on those stages because they're so dark compared to the others. I feel like that's literally the only advantage that I think you could give the other two. But at this point right now, yes, like you said, the stages are a little less important in doubles, but we're sticking with all the same characters, and now it's a matter of getting this offense in and making sure that both opponents are far away from each other as much as possible.
So now we're going to jump into Town and City, a little open stage. Stage I can convert into Final Destination for a brief moment, as well as has those platforms in the mid. And honestly, it gives them plenty of breathing room, which is something that they thrive off of, in my honest opinion.
They're starting with the quick attack C4. Pikachu already has the C4. It's on Joker.
I mean, in all honesty, they've been doing that a lot. I think that's like one of their game plans to start off the games with, off the sets with, is just, you know, Pelka applying that C4 to Pikachu because it's the beginning of neutral. No one can really close the gap just yet, so no. It's like a free opening.
Arsene already for 6WX, and we're like 20 seconds into this match.
And that's not necessarily impressive for 6WX because that means he just got his ass whooped for a sec.
Yeah.
No, he's already at 83%. Hey.
Oh, the C4 being planted right there. Got to be careful that side of the stage now. Uno standing basically right on it, too.
Scoops him up with the up smash. Hits him with the grenade afterwards.
Realizing that down smash and coming down with the down air. Really good job with 6WX there.
Good pickup. You saw him putting him down with a down throw, but DM was just a little too short away from that with that forward smash.
Nice. That up tilt once again.
Fantastic anti-air. You know, it's super quick out of shield. You got to respect it. A lot of players' first instinct to do when they're holding shield is the jump in this game because it's one of the fastest. faster options, one of the safest options. Mm-hmm. So because of that, the metagame starts to evolve into this whole, oh my god. I mean, honestly, you see the rapid jab happening. It gives 6WX all the time in the world because Pelka was too busy offstage trying to get back. Okay, good pick.
Going low, no tech.
He can make it.
See the C4.
Good save from DM. He's smacking with the up air to get him back onto the stage. And because of the rapid jab actually coming out from Uno, 6WX was actually stuck in the middle of shield, so he couldn't do anything about Pelko's recovery. Because Snake is so abusable when he's recovering from low.
Oh, absolutely. And like, he has super armor to it, but if you just get rid of that, thing, it's gone. Mm. It's dead. He goes into free fall.
And 200% on Pelka. My man's living the dream. Snake is a big boy. Dash attack is just a quick burst option. Interesting jump air dodge. Gets caught by the grenade. Catches him with the C4. I think he wanted to go for another C4 against 6WX. I was hanging on the middle of the stage. Yeah. Now, Pelka's going to chill back. Just throw out those grenades. You're in the back line, son.
Literally, he's not a frontline man anymore. He's saying, Sarge, I'm gonna stay back a little bit. I'll be on lookout.
Well, at this point, he's a glass cannon. Blue team needs to get rid of this snake, dude. I don't know what's going on. Pelka living the dream.
214 right now, and that's gonna do it.
There we go.
Even without Arsene, that up air is gonna do it at 214.
Finally finds the up air he's been looking for the whole time, and now Pelka's with a fresh stock. And a snake with a lead is a scary character to deal with.
Absolutely.
Because he wants to go for those trades, man.
The only character not in the hundreds right now. Either.
What happened to Six?
I couldn't even tell you.
He just fell. There's a miscommunication there. I wonder if he actually flubbed one of his recoveries.
That could easily be a possibility. And this at C4 actually killing DM.
No, I mean, when you play Snake in doubles, it can be insanely tough to keep track
absolutely.
Of, as your teammate, it's insanely hard to keep track of, all the explosions that are going on, the grenades, the C4s.
I was saying that earlier, in doubles, you already have to focus on not only your opponents, but your partner. But when your partner is a Snake, you have to focus on not only him, but all his projectiles are just laying on the ground.
But the red team, New England, still have that stock lead against 6WX's team, the Brothers.
But the Brothers with firm stage control right
good.
Now.
I mean, that was a good call out. And oh no, Pelka! I think he air dodged through the ledge, so he didn't actually pick up on it. And now he put DM in his tight spot. He just needs to get one kill, though. He's on a completely fresh stock. No damage applied to him. But now the damage can easily start to rack up. Taken away. Good call out from 6WX. He actually went for the dash attack because he knew that Uno was right behind him. Tried to pick up in case he rolls to the left. But now 6WX coming in. Wants the grappler.
Does that Rebel's guard.
Going off stage, has the gun ready to go. DM trying to find his way back onto the stage. Regains that invincibility because he took a hit. Back center stage. He's trying to play safe. As I say, he goes for a very raw dash attack right on the shield. Sets him up for success. Gets the neutral air into an up smash. And now we have ourselves an even game. DM versus 6WX. This is really important. 6WX manages to take this stock. He gets the reset of the bracket. And DM definitely wants to resent that. Trying to fight it. Trying to play safe. Throwing out these thunder jolts.
Is that good?
Thunder, Arsene's right through it. I mean, that's what he has to be aware of. I mean, it's just a habit for DM at this point. You know, you get that down throw, might as well throw out that thunder. Try again.
Down throw, trying to get the read with the DI.
That would have reflected back at Pikachu. That was insanely scary. DM's got to be super careful about the Tetracarn. Down air, or down tilt.
Arsene still around for a tiny bit here. That forward tilt coming out.
One hit away from resetting this bracket.
He's
can he do it?
Friend.
He wants a back air. Oh, he whiffs the forward tilts, giving himself a wide opening for DM to go in there and just skull bash him with a dash stack.
All it took is that one little miss, and he was literally about to lose Arsene too. He was on the cusp.
Here was the game-defining moment right here. This whiffed forward tilt. He saw it happening. He was too slow. He was too slow, so he came in with a dash attack and just, headbutted him.
And this is game five now.
Game five, one game away from ending the tournament.
This could be the end of doubles here at Smashadelphia.
They were so close to resetting the bracket, and now Pelka, DM. We finally had DM get that 2v1 situation and found victory over it. And that is no easy task.
See, and we talked today about how, especially now in this top four, all we've seen are 3-0s. We could be on the cusp of our first reverse 3-0, and our only reverse 3-0, really. Literally... This is a huge opportunity now for Pelka and DM to just close out everything, go home happy. But right now...
They're diffusing that momentum.
Yeah. Six and Uno. Strong, strong two games. And it's not like games 3 and 4 were super decisive. They were all super close. But Pelka and DM just found something.
6-0 could be a little bit shaken up to be that close to resetting the bracket. Now have two games. Let's see if they can do something here. Going to stick with the same characters. Let's see if I have a change of pace with the stages at least. Maybe just like a different type of momentum shift. The thing is, they had a pretty strong thing going there. They just couldn't find the closeout deal against DM. Like they got really lucky with Pelka going for that SD off stage earlier. But here we go. We're going to finish things off on Unova.
Now, this is a stage where I was saying earlier, the stage is a little darker. And talking with a lot of Snake players, they actually really prefer this stage because once that C4 red light goes away, it's actually a lot harder to keep track of it. If it's under this like little platform area right there, it's much harder to see actually compared onto a stage like, say, Smashville, for example. This stage suits Snake a lot better. But right now, we got to see what a Joker and an Inkling can make out of this stage.
That's a benefit for Snake, too, in doubles, especially, because there's so much chaos, you're not always looking. If you're in singles, it's up to you to be able to be like listen for that audio cue, because you're only watching one player, you know?
Exactly.
But now there's like three players on screen besides yourself.
There's so much chaos, you could easily forget about it.
So here we go, jumping right into it. Pretty even so far. DM has a potential edge guard against six, but Arsene's coming out. Aegon, give himself some breathing room. And what's this spike?
Wow.
He knew he was going to go for a back air. Gets the counter. I believe that was Uno.
Yeah, I think that was
that
Uno's
finished it
move
off.
That actually
my man sent
it
out a draw four. Sent him flying.
And there goes Uno, actually six staying alive. That back air is sending DM far off a little bit, but able to get right back to stage. Going for that up smash. Going for that forward smash. Wow, my God.
The double up smash, not able to find its mark. Okay, DM and 6WX still at their first stocks. As I say that, there goes 6, and there goes DM. Punish for a punish.
The dash attack from DM was basically the end of it all, but Uno's move was actually what finished 6 off in the end.
Okay, going for the Rebel's Guard offstage again. 6WX trying to find this mark. Pelka opting to recover low because he knows he's going to go for the air dodge, directional air dodge to get back onto the ledge. Arsene is back in effect. Again, he gets Arsene so fast because his teammate taking damage, gives him meter. Again, some more Aegons coming out from 6. Pelka and DM just trying to hold center that corner a bit, hoping to just throw out projectiles.
Hell yeah, Pelka throwing all these grenades right now. The C4 actually being on that top platform right there. Nothing connected though, but these grenades are coming out left and right. But as you said, that reflect, the Tetracon, is it?
Yeah. Yeah. Oh no, that was a Makarakarn.
Oh my God, the double parry coming out. The down smash, gonna kill only Uno, and Uno's down on his final stock now.
There we go. Good bounce from Pelka, gets back onto the stage. You see him pulling out grenades again and again. He waited for the grenade to explode, recognizing that it was right there. Popped Uno up into the air, goes for the back air, catches another upset, but dies in the process again. A punish for a punish. And we're going back into our final stocks for every competitor.
This is a super dangerous situation. This will either continue the bracket completely or end the tournament right now. And Uno air dodging so low. I thought Uno had actually SD'd right there, but able to get back to stage. There was a C4 planted center stage. I actually think, it's still there.
Okay, gets back on.
Gotta watch center stage right here. Right on top of Uno!
Everyone just exploded, and now we have ourselves a 1v1 again. Pelka versus Uno.
Nikita coming out.
Uno needs this stock hero to try to continue playing. Gets a good, catches the tech in play, sends him flying with a rapid jab. That was actually a mix-up from Pelka. He's going super deep for the down air. Again, Inkling can afford to do that, so why not do it, especially against the likes of Snake?
And getting the parry off on that C4, that could have been a super dangerous situation right there.
We got Kickies. Looking for it again, but he kicked the grenade in the process. Almost got caught by that up air. Pelka on the verge of becoming Smashadelphia's champion.
Low ink for Uno right now. Uno needs to find a way to get something here. Waited out that back air. Yeah, that was super good. Just a little too early.
And he shield pushed him with the up tilt, so he couldn't connect that grab. Uno could get a lot off of a grab at this point. Hold on a second. He had to jump away from that grenade. Sends out the Nikita missile. Mixes him up. Catches the air dodge. Reverses its trajectory. Explodes right into Inkling's noggin. And sends him in to out of the bracket. That's going to be the tournament for doubles. Your champions from New England, DM and Pelka.